China's expansionism resembles Nazi army, and Xi Jinping is leaving no stone unturned to match Hitler, as was the case in World War II. Russia's Vladivostok is going to be Xi Jinping's Stalingrad moment. China doesn't want friends. It doesn't want peaceful borders either. The only thing that China wants is territory, more and more of it. An expansionist, China is already claiming the maritime territory of other countries in the South China Sea, the East China Sea, and Indian territory in eastern Ladakh in the Himalayas. But now, it is also laying its eyes on Russia's far eastern port city, Vladivostok. But China must note that there is always an end to expansionism and belligerence. In its heydays, even an imperial Japan or a Nazi army would have thought that they were unstoppable. If China succumbs under the weight of its own expansionist tendencies, it will certainly not be the first giant bully to die such a painful death. And in fact, China's Stalingrad moment might already be here. China made fresh claims on Russian territory as the Russian embassy posted a video to celebrate the 160th anniversary of Vladivostok on the Chinese social media website Weibo. Chinese internet users, including diplomats and officials, claim that Vladivostok used to be part of China. They claim it was Chiang's Manchurian homeland, but was annexed by the Russian Empire in 1860 after China was defeated by the British and the French during the Second Opium War. But China's claims over Russia's Vladivostok are not limited to the state-owned media and internet users. Chinese diplomats have jumped in. Zhang Heqing, a wolf warrior from China currently stationed at the country's mission in Pakistan, said, "Isn't this what in the past was our Haishinwai?" Meanwhile, the CCP 50 Cent Army too has gone berserk. A Weibo user wrote, "Today we can only endure, but the Chinese people will remember, and one generation after another will continue to remember." SCMP quotes another user as saying, "We must believe that this ancestral land will return home in the future." This is how China starts making territorial claims. First, it initiates conversations, claiming that it owns a particular part of another country's territory. Then, its state media starts laying claim. And then it moves ahead with confrontations around the borders and military buildups, starting with a salami slicing tactic. The move to reclaim Vladivostok, which is not far from the Sino-Russia border, could lead to a new era of confrontation between Moscow and Beijing. This effectively brings an end to the show of ostensible camaraderie between the two countries. Russia has been compelled to move close to China owing to the sanctions that have been imposed by the US and other Western powers. But that could be overshadowed with border disputes. China's expansionism is testing the patience of the world. It has border disputes with over 21 nations and it just keeps provoking all of them. China's fresh claims could push its mad medieval rush for territory towards a decisive end. For it is reminiscent of the Battle of Stalingrad, that is when an aggressive and expansionist Nazi Germany made a move that proved to be the undoing of the Nazi forces. Named after the Soviet dictator Joseph Stalin, Stalingrad, now known as Volgograd, stood on the banks of the Volga River and was recognized as a strategically important city. During the Second World War, overconfident on account of initial gains, Hitler launched a major offensive in southern Russia in the summers of 1942. He was seeking to annihilate what was left of the Soviet army. Ultimately, he wanted to capture the Caucasus oil fields. The initial advances went well, but ultimately the Soviet troops would soon encircle the Germans from the banks of the Volga. Ordered by Hitler not to back out, General Friedrich von Paulus led 6th German Army somehow endured till February before giving in. 500,000 German troops lost their lives and another 91,000 surrendered as they were trapped inside the city by the Soviets. This was a turning point in the Second World War. Momentum on the Eastern Front shifted due to the Battle of Stalingrad. CCP is making the same error that the Nazis too committed during the Second World War, by raking up a territorial dispute with Russia. Vladivostok is Xi Jinping's Stalingrad as the People's Republic of China moves towards an imminent downfall.